Assert has some ability. He's got some natural ability. He's got a good skill set. The one thing that you do like is his speed. He's shown the ability on some of our stretch plays. Once he gets the edge, I mean, he can get an extra gear. You know, he's got to, have to back up and slow down because he accelerates so quickly into the line of scrimmage and kind of throws off the blocking scheme. But, you know, he's a guy that we're going to work with. He's got to learn patience. It's only his second, third practice. So, but I like where he is, and he's eager to learn. And I like that part of it.
Obviously, he made a name for himself at running back at the junior college level and in high school. What was kind of the thought process of bringing him over from cornerback?
Well, right now we're looking at, if you look at our depth chart, we got Corey, and then we have two guys, in my opinion, battling for that second spot in Darre and Caleb Kenlaw's here. You know, he's been injured. He's coming back. We got another young man walking on Marshawn. You know, so we got some guys outside those three that's been injured and had a lot of reps. So to bring a guy along that's healthy, that has some background in playing the position, and cut him loose, see what he can do.
So as you mentioned, Taiwan and Darre battling, is that a close competition right now? I know beginning of camp you said Darre is definitely your number two, but is Taiwan really caught up there?
That gap is closed dramatically, and that's really if in spring ball, that's probably the one thing that's happened. That's the one true competition, and I like to create competition at the running back position. And those two guys they're battling back and forth, and both Darwin's gotten so much better than he in practice one. Now he's fought through some things, and he's shown some toughness and things that, you know, that truly I had questions about when I got here, trying to find out how tough he was. But he's fought through some things, and he's proven that he can step in and he can play and be productive.
Is that what's impressed you the most about Taiwan, his toughness? Or?
Oh, without a doubt, his toughness. His ability. He's got a poor quad right now, and he hadn't missed a rep. You know, he was able to break a long run down the sideline last practice and ran away from the secondary. So when he's playing ball, he's totally locked in and focused on playing ball. And then when he comes off, then he might give you a limp or two. But I like the fact that he can focus and lock in and overcome those types of things.
The last couple years, running backs haven't gotten a lot of live carries in spring and fall camp. And most Corey's has been going up. He's been getting tackled. Why do you kind of choose to let the defense, I guess, hit him live rather than maybe the last couple of years where they've been forced to lay off?
I'm an old school guy. I mean, and I don't want them to get a lot of hits, but I think guys, to play running back, you have to play the position, and that's part of it. I think your body has to be physically fit and ready to take on hits. So I don't want to give them a lot of tackles, but they have to feel contact for ball security purposes, that type of thing, be able to secure the ball, feel guys hitting them, making sure they got the ball in the proper position, that type of thing. And then just prove it to themselves that they can run through tackles. We do so much tag off, the guys kind of get a false sense of security. So I like for them to be run, get tackled, have to get the pads down, that type of thing.
Do you kind of expect to use a similar plan in the spring game in terms of mock carries you got about today?
Probably not. He'll probably get a lot less carries. Okay. I like the fact, when it's thud and he's not getting taken to the ground, I like the contact. When we start taking to the ground, I'm in the 5 to 10 rep range.
Did you like to see Corey break off a few really long runs today? What did you think? He looked really good.
Yeah, I thought he looked really good. I thought he had a couple where he ran through some arm tackles and the one touchdown run he had later on in the practice. He made a couple people miss, and I ran a few guys to the corner of the end zone. I think that, for me, that's what I want to see. I just want to see him be able to put his foot down, change direction, and being able to open up and make some and create some things at the second, third level. I think creativity at the running back position is something that a lot of people lack. So I like to see guys what are they going to do when they're confronted with a backer or safety? What are they going to have to run over them? Can they create, make a guy miss, and go score? So I was happy to see him do that on a handful of occasions.
this group is going to change quite a bit this fall. There's two more coming in. Do you view those guys as early impact guys that can compete for that number two job?
I never put boundaries on anybody. I'd say a number two job, probably not. But because I think the two guys that are battling out right now are going to continue to progress, and they're going to be very good come fall camp. With having the spring under their belt and then having the summer to really learn this offense and work on it during, you know, June and July. But I do hope that the two guys that are coming in will be able to come in and compete in camp and be able to function and make things competitive and have an opportunity to maybe make the squad and impact the season down the road.